Welcome back, viewers. This is Lanco's Educational Services Limited. Don't forget to check our website, which is streaming on the screen down below. You can also contact us on WhatsApp on the number showing on the screen. You can drop your questions online. You can also discuss problems that you need to solve online. You can also tell your friends about us for any topic of interest that they might be bothersome to them. We can make videos on them and discuss them intensively. Okay, so during our last class, tertiary biomolecules, another biomolecules, we picked out carbohydrate as our first subtopic. Under carbohydrate is called the classifications, which is classification based on functional group and classification based on number of monomers. Now, under the number of monomers, we started with monosaccharides being the basic units for the formation of other types of carbohydrates. Now, under monosaccharides, we've discussed the 3-carbon sugar, which is triglyceraldehyde, as our major example. We've also discussed the 5-carbon sugar, ribose, as our major example, giving the 3D structures for both. Now, we shall move into our 6-carbon sugar, discussing glucose and fructose and their structures. Now, for glucose, we have... Now, for the 6-carbon glucose, we have a straight line structure as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, one thing you know is that glucose and fructose are actually both 6-carbon sugars, although they have different functional groups. They exhibit what we call functional group isomerism, okay? Whereby they have the same molecular formula but different functional groups. So, for glucose is actually an aldose sugar, while fructose is a ketose sugar. So, we have the functional group CHO, then HOH, OH. H, OH, H, OH, H, OH, OH, H. So this is the structure for your glucose. This is a straight line structure. Now remember that I said to form a cyclic structure, the compound, the carbon atom carrying the functional group and the second to the last, they react together. So that means that this carbon atom here is going to react to the second to the last one to form a cyclic structure. So by the reaction now, the OH from the second to the last moves to the first one. The bond here breaks, therefore combining oxygen to this one here. So like this now, we're now going to have a cyclic structure. You could also decide to say from C1 to C5. C1 to C5 reaction leads to cyclic structure. Okay. So from here we have the cyclic structure. And usually the cyclic structure is in form of a hexagon. So you have this oxygen. Then the first carbon atom carries hydrogen and OH. The second carbon atom is carrying OH and H. The third one is carrying H and OH. The sixth one is still carrying H and OH. While the last one at this point is carrying hydrogen and this last compound, CH2OH. So you have hydrogen and can test with anyone first. So in this manner, now the third, now remember I said when the OH is down below, what you have is an alpha structure. But when the OH comes up here, what you now have is a beta structure, given the 3-dimensional structures for glucose. Now the last one we'll be discussing is fructose before we move into disaccharides. Now for fructose, like I said, has the same formula with glucose, but they have different functional group in the sense that fructose has a ketose functional group on carbon 2. So this is the ketone functional group. Then you have H, OH. So this is the structure for the straight line structure for fructose. Then I mentioned that when the carbon atom carrying the functional group and the second to the last react, we are going to have a cyclic structure. So that means that for this, it will be C2 to C5 reaction. So by that, now the OH from here comes to this place, while the double bond breaks, combining oxygen with this. So now the structure for this is actually going to be a pentagon, which is similar to that of ribose sugar. Now, the cyclic structure for fructose is actually known as furan because it bears resemblance to another organic compound which has the same cyclic structure. So you have oxygen, carbon. The first carbon here is carrying CH2OH and OH. So you have CH2OH and OH. The second carbon here is carrying So like I said, the reaction between C2 to C5 here brings about the cyclic structure. So this OH comes up here, you have OH, then oxygen double bond breaks, combining oxygen C2 to C5. Remember the OH has moved up here. So combining C2 to C5, you have this connection, okay? So you have that this carbon C2 here is one carrying C1 and OH, C1 and OH. Then the next carbon atom is carrying H and OH, H, OH. The next carbon is carrying OH and H, OH and H. While the last carbon atom, this C5, is carrying both hydrogen and this whole compound. So it's carrying CH2OH and hydrogen. So this now gives you the cyclic structure for fructose, which is similar to that of ribose sugar. Okay, so this is now its alpha structure. The alpha structure is when the OH on carbon 2 now is down here. When the OH comes up, you're now going to have it as this. And that now becomes a beta structure. So that is the three-dimensional structure for fructose. And with this, this concludes monosaccharide. So in our next class, I'll be moving into disaccharides. Once again, this is Lamposa Educational Services Limited. Contact us on WhatsApp and on other social media platforms, which is streaming down on the screen below.